Hello everyone. So today we are gonna find the Laplace transform of hyperbolic cos a t by using the definition of Laplace transform. Now for that I'll write down the function. So we want to find Laplace of hyperbolic cos of a t. Now to get the answer we will use the definition. So what is the definition of Laplace transform? So here I'll say by the definition of Laplace transform, we have Laplace of f of t as integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt. So this is the definition of Laplace transform. Now as we want to find out the Laplace transform of cos h a t or hyperbolic cos a t, will start here. So Laplace of hyperbolic cos a t. So if I'll compare this with the property or with the definition of Laplace transform, then here we can easily say that f of t is equal to hyperbolic cos a t. It means on the right hand side also I will substitute f of t as hyperbolic cos a t. So here we'll get integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus st hyperbolic cos a t dt. Now to solve this integration, that is integration of e raised to minus st hyperbolic cos a t with respect to t, we are going to substitute the formula for hyperbolic cos a t. Now what is the formula of hyperbolic cos a t? So here I'll say that the hyperbolic cos of theta is given by the formula e raised to theta plus e raised to minus theta upon 2. So this is the general formula of hyperbolic function in terms of exponential function. Now if you'll compare this hyperbolic cos theta with hyperbolic cos a t, then we can easily say that this theta is like a t or theta is equal to a t. So it means on the right hand side I'll get e raised to a t plus e raised to minus a t upon 2 because theta is a t. So let's write it down. So here we'll get integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus st into e raised to a t plus e raised to minus a t upon 2 into dt. Now this 1 upon 2 is constant, so I will take it outside the integration. Here we will get integration 0 to infinity and now we will multiply this bracket with e raised to minus st. So here in the first term we will get e raised to minus st into e raised to a t. So what is e raised to minus st into e raised to a t? So when we multiply two exponential terms having the same base, that time we add the exponents. So here the exponents are minus st and a t. So let's add it. So here we'll get e raised to minus st plus a t, or I can take t common from two terms and in the bracket I'll get e raised to minus s plus a into t. So by multiplication of these two terms we are gonna get e raised to minus s plus a into t. Middle sign is plus. Now let's multiply the second term, that is e raised to minus a t, with e raised to minus st, and here also we are gonna use the same formula, the same property. So by doing that here we'll get e raised to minus s minus a into t into dt. So we got two exponential terms in the integration. Now we have to integrate these two terms with respect to t. So let's integrate. So for that we are gonna use the formula of integration as integration of e raised to f of t dt equal to, now which is equal to e raised to f of t upon derivative of this f of t. So now I will use this formula. So according to this formula here we'll get 1 by 2 e raised to minus s plus a into t upon the derivative of minus s plus a into t, and that derivative is minus s plus a. Similarly here, by using the formula, we will get e raised to minus s minus a into t upon the derivative of minus s minus a the whole bracket into t. So the derivative of this part is minus s minus a, and limits are from 0 to infinity. So now we got the value of integration. Now we have to substitute the upper and lower limit. So before that, what we'll do is we'll simplify the second term. How? So in the second term, if you'll observe carefully, then we have a minus sign common in minus s and minus a. So we can take that minus sign outside. So by doing that, we will get one by two e raised to minus s plus a into t upon minus s plus a e raised to minus sign outside s plus a into t upon, here also I'll take minus sign outside, that is common, and this plus will become negative because of that minus sign. So plus minus is minus, middle sign is minus, and here we'll get s plus a from 0 to infinity. Now let's substitute the upper and lower limit. So the upper limit is infinity. So here we'll get 1 by 2 e raised to minus s plus a into infinity. So that will become infinity. But let me tell you, my friends, if you will put this t as infinity and if you are getting e raised to infinity, then the value of e raised to infinity is infinity. So it means you will get one term as infinity, and therefore infinity plus or minus anything is infinity, and you will get your answer as infinity. So don't do this mistake. Whereas we have one more formula, that is e raised to minus infinity is 0. So if we'll get 0 in the answer, it is manageable. But e raised to infinity is equal to infinity is not accepted. So for that, what I will do is I will try to make that term as e raised to minus infinity. Now how I'll do it, see here. So for that, I will take minus sign common from here. So automatically I'll get e raised to minus, and in bracket we'll get positive s minus a. Okay. So this positive s minus a into t upon this minus s plus a can be like this only. Here the term is same, that is e raised to minus s plus a into t upon s plus a, and limits are from 0 to infinity. Now if you'll observe that, now if we'll substitute infinity at t, then here you will get infinity but with minus sign. It means we are successful to bring the term e raised to minus infinity, and that is equal to 0. So now let's substitute the upper limit. So 1 by 2 as it is, upper limit is infinity, this will become e raised to minus infinity upon minus s plus a minus e raised to minus infinity upon s plus a. So this is the upper limit substitution. Now let's substitute the lower limit. Middle sign is negative, so lower limit is 0. This will become e raised to 0 upon minus s plus a minus e raised to 0 upon s plus a. Now we know that e raised to minus infinity is 0. So the first term is 0 minus 0, which is 0, minus e raised to 0 is 1. So here we'll get 1 upon minus s plus a in bracket minus 1 upon s plus a. So 1 by 2 as it is, this will become negative, and here we can do the cross multiplication. So we'll get in bracket s plus a minus 1 into minus s plus a upon minus s plus a into s plus a. Now here we'll get 1 by 2, and I'll take this minus sign outside, so minus 1 by 2. In the bracket we'll get s plus a, this will become plus s minus a upon, now here I will rewrite this term as a minus s. It means I have taken the first term as second and second term as first. So I am not making the big difference. And this term as a plus s again. Now why I am doing this? Because in the denominator we can get the formula a minus b a plus b. And here a and a will be cancelled. So we will get 2s. Here we will get minus 1 by 2, that is minus sign here, 2 here. And we can get a square minus s square in the denominator. Now this 2 and 2 will be cancelled and we will shift this minus sign in the denominator. So this s is as it is. Now because of this minus sign, this positive a square will become negative a square and this negative s square will become positive s square. And hence we got the value of Laplace transform of hyperbolic cos at. So here I can say that Laplace of hyperbolic cos at is equal to s upon s square minus a square. So we have derived this formula by using the definition of Laplace transform. Thank you.